festivals and what we should do and what they are supposed to do.
It's going
to
be on YouTube.
He talks about Zedekiah. Zedekiah, which is righteousness, the righteous act. This is something that is seen very unnatural. You know, we never want to give up what we have because we always have that attitude that it's mine. I work hard for this. Why should I give you my stuff? When we don't have a lot, we say, I need what I have. I'm not giving it away to nobody just because we need it. And you know, we do it so much that sometimes it becomes a common practice. It becomes a common practice for us a lot of times. And then because the Torah goes out of its way to urge us against doing things like this. In this parsha, it mentions in this parsha again almost verbatim when we talk about reaping the harvest of the land. It said, and when you reap the harvest of your land, you should not reap all the way to the edges of your field or gather the gleanings of your harvest. You should leave them for the poor and for the stranger. I am the Lord your God. Now I know you say, why does it repeat itself? We're talking about the law of the festival, marking the completion of the harvest season. You see, during the harvest season, it's a joyous time. And in joy, a lot of times we can forget the poor. After having a successful harvest or accomplishment in our lives, you know, we want to keep everything for ourselves. But you know, we have to remember that we don't own anything on this earth. Everything that we have is meant to us. We have it for borrowed time. Everything belongs to eternity. But in our time that we have what we have, we should not become selfish with what we have. A lot of times that's what a lot of us do. You see, the poor and the stranger, they are God's people just like you and I are. And the Father gives to us, so we should do the same for others and give to others. You see, one thing you should forget is that when you give to others, there's blessings in giving to others, especially when you don't know a person and they don't know you. If we just did what the Eternal wanted us to do, you know, by helping each other, we'll watch all the blessings come down. But see, sometimes, you know, this can be hard to do. It can be hard when we have limited resources or we are in a financial hardship. See, during economic crisis, the poor are hit harder than the average person. And remember, there are people out there who are worse off than we are. And even those people who feel that they don't have anything, there's worse people off than even they are. So this is why the Torah reminds us that we are not to keep the entire field for ourselves. It didn't say whether the farmer had a good or bad year. Then you should give to him. Only that we are to leave the corners of the field for the poor and the stranger. See, even the poor have an obligation to feel better. Right. They have to do their portion as well. We should remember our obligation to the poor in times of plenty and in times of need. Let us struggle to rise above our natural reactions to hoard out of pride and fear. The earth provides enough resources for every man, for every woman, for every child to live comfortably. However, there are those people in power who choose to hoard it all. Sometimes when things go wrong for us, we get afraid and we fear the worst. We need to stop being afraid of what could go wrong and start being positive about what could go right. You see, we are not here on this earth to see through each other. We are here to see each other through.
There you go.
We have to learn how to set our minds on things above and not on the earthly things. We should always be thankful and remember how rich we really are. We have our families. Our families are priceless. Our time is gold, and our health is our wealth. Because we can't So we have to enjoy the time while we have here and make the most of the time while we are here on this planet. But you know what? Sometimes we let people take us off our path. Because we allow them to influence our decisions and sometimes our directions in life. Some people, you know, we just don't need them in our life. We just don't need them. People will always notice the change in your attitude towards them, but they fail to notice it's their behavior that needs to change. And remember this. The knives that people stick in your back can become very useful when it's time to cut your ties with them. And you know we have a lot of them out there. They do anything they can to cut you down. But you know what? You don't have to explain anything to them. Because all it does is create ill feelings towards one another. Don't waste your words on people who deserve your silence. Sometimes the most powerful thing you can say is nothing at all. You see, the Creator, He's still in the blessing business. He has never left the blessing business. Especially when you are a person who gives of your heart. Sometimes you give of your time. And people really appreciate when you go over and beyond and just reach out to them. But I don't mean foolishly, because the Eternal has given us wisdom to discern whether someone is trying to pull a fast one on you or not. People don't like to see others being blessed for acts of kindness. We can't let the devil and other people defeat us. We can't let people disillusion us. We can't let even the weather weary us or sickness to stop us. We can't let money buy us or the government silence us. Because you know what? We are the children of the Most High God. Amen. There is nothing that He can't have. All we have to do is put our faith in Him and know that He can handle all things. As far as those people who try to rain on your parade, you just have to turn around, give them a little smile, throw a match and burn that bridge. Unconditional. Yes. And don't waste it on those that only love you when the conditions are right for them. So we must never ignore someone who cares for us. Because someday you'll realize that you lost time while you were busy collecting songs. If you stop telling your friends everything, your enemy wouldn't know so much. We can't spend our time worrying about those who talk behind our backs, because they are behind you for a reason. If we learn to turn our words into worship, we can start to watch Hashem turn our battles into blessings. God never commanded us to trust people. God commanded us to love people and to trust Him only. We should learn the difference, because our joy and our victory depends on it. Sometimes people try to expose what's wrong with you, because they can't handle what's right about you. I guess sometimes we should bring our enemies a chair, since they can't stand to see us get blessed. We have to keep the faith that the Eternal will guide us through this journey called life. You see, faith is like Wi-Fi. It's invisible, but it has the power to connect you to what you need. Okay. If we learn to leave everything in God's hand, we will eventually see that God's hand is in everything we do. All of these fake friends that we have, they are like shadows. They follow you in the sun, but they leave your side when it gets dark. Just because our paths are different, it don't mean that I'm lost. When God has selected you, it doesn't matter who else has rejected you or neglected you. See, God's favor outweighs all opposition, and that makes you a winner. There are many evil plans against us by the enemy. But you know what? As long as we have eternal, their plans will never work. You see, sometimes in order to hear God's plan, we have to let go of our own. It's not about taking shortcuts in life. It's about following the right paths. God answers us in three ways. He says yes, and he gives us what you want. He says no, and he gives you something better. Or he says wait, and then he'll give you the best. When we learn how much we are worth, we will stop being discounts. Don't change from doing the will of eternal. We have to continue to doing his will by giving up our heart and giving to the needs of others. And if we continue to do that, just wait and see how much we will be blessed. Shabbat shalom.